Welcome to this session on tuberculosis notification. We all know that tuberculosis remains a major public health challenge in India. TB is a major killer amongst all the infectious diseases. Despite of national TB program since 1962 and all the efforts, tuberculosis burden in India remains the highest in the world. There are reasons for this. 2/3 of the patients, TB patients, seek care from private sector. Despite of private sector engagement schemes, patients going to the private sector remained outside the ambit of the tuberculosis program in India. Though tuberculosis was notifiable in few states, corporations since many years, many decades, but still really not very well implemented. So, this was one of the reasons on 7th May 2012, TB notification order was issued by the central government, which makes it mandatory for all the laboratories, the practitioners and the hospitals who either diagnose or treat TB to notify to the nodal officers at the district level. Immediately after that, on 21st July 2015, the first amendment came. There were reasons for this, we will see in detail what were the reasons, and another amendment is expected soon in December 2017. If we see globally and in India also and compare it, there is a gap between the total notification rate and the expected incidence. Globally, the incidence rate is going down while the notification was stationary, but recently in last 3-4 years, the notification rate has increased, which we can see on the left side. On the right side, we can see more or less the notification by the program was stationary over last 6-7 years, and which has increased, which was started declining 4 years before, it has again started increasing with implementation of TB notification in India. So, we will see what are the objectives of this TB notification. It is to establish tuberculosis surveillance system in the country, to ensure proper TB diagnosis and case management and further accelerate reduction of tuberculosis transmission, to extend the mechanism of TB treatment adherence, contact tracings to patients not only treated in the public sector, but also in the private sector, to mitigate the impending drug resistant tuberculosis epidemic in the country by bringing in ambit all the patients including the private sector in the ambit of care, including the follow up. So, why this TB notification is important? We all know surveillance is the key for tackling any menace of a disease. Notification is the first step. Patient benefit should be at the center. Public health action is needed, and unless and until it is done, any notification will not have any value. It also intends to improve the quality of care, and so is the coverage. Unless and until we saw the patients which were outside the ambit of the care being treated in the private sector, unless and until those are covered, the quality of care is improved, we are unlikely to reach our main aim of TB control in this country. So, what is the information that is required to be notified? What is the basis of TB diagnosis? There are two types. First is microbiologically confirmed tuberculosis, and by definition, a TB patient diagnosed with at least one clinical specimen positive for acid fast bacilli or culture positive for mycobacterium tuberculosis by or RNTCP approved diagnostic molecular test positive for tuberculosis will amount to a microbiologically confirmed TB case, or it can be a clinical TB case, a patient diagnosed clinically as TB without microbiological confirmation and initiated on TB anti-TB drugs. So, these are the information basis of diagnosis that needs to be reported. Then what is the type of the patient? There are three types of patient. that is included in the notification. First is new TB case, a patient who has never been treated with anti-TB drugs or has been treated with anti-TB drugs for less than 1 month from any source, whether it is public or private, amounts to a new case. It can be a recurrent case if the patient has been treated for tuberculosis in the past and has been declared successfully treated, that includes cured patients and the treatment completed at the end of their treatment regimen. And treatment change, these are the patients returning after interruption or the patients put on new regimen, new treatment regimen, and due to failure of the current treatment regimen. These will be the treatment change patients. So, these are the types of patients that the treating facility has to notify. Now, what are the site of disease? We all know there are the site of the disease is a, can be either pulmonary, that is a patient with tuberculosis of lungs with or without involvement of any extra pulmonary locations. And the other type is extra pulmonary TB case, that is the patient with tuberculosis of any organ other than the lungs, such as pleura, lymph node, intestines, genitourinary tract, skin, bones, joints, meninges, etcetera, diagnosed with microbiological, histological, radiological or strong clinical evidence. We also need to think about rifampicin resistance, and that has been included when we report, when we notify a tuberculosis case. So, what is expected? A definition of a rifampicin resistant case is drug susceptibility test result from RNT certified laboratory or a WHO endorsed rapid diagnostic drug susceptibility test report showing the resistance to rifampicin. And what is the rifampicin sensitive case? A patient with a drug susceptibility result from same RNTCP certified laboratory or WHO endorsed rapid molecular test, which are the drug susceptibility test results showing drug sensitivity to rifampicin. Now, there will be instances, there will be situations where you do not have the DST, the drug susceptibility test done, or the result is not available. In such case, the test result is not available and that needs to be reported. But over a period of time, the intention is to increase this drug susceptibility testing, and by policy within the program now, universal drug susceptibility testing for rifampicin is the policy. Now, what are the RNTCP endorsed TB diagnostics? We talk about the smear microscopy for AFB, sputum smear stained with Zill-Nielsen staining or fluorescent stains with examined under direct or indirect microscopy with or without LED is smear microscopy, which is endorsed. For culture, it is the either solid culture with LJ media or liquid culture, whether it is semi-automatic or automatic, that is BACTEC or MAGIT. And there are rapid diagnostic molecular tests, which includes the real-time PCR based line probe assay for MTB complex or the nucleic acid amplification test, NAT test. One example is Gene Expert, which is already there. We call it CBNAT, cartridge based nucleic acid amplification test in India, and the another one is coming soon, which is being validated as TrueNAT. So, these are the RNTCP endorsed TB diagnostics. Now, who is expected to notify a TB patient? We saw for operational purposes, the health establishments are divided into three categories. Who are expected to notify TB patients? First is laboratories. These are the laboratories where the RNTCP endorsed diagnostics takes place and the TB patients are diagnosed. Private practitioners or clinics, which are single, any health establishment where a TB case patient is treated or diagnosed clinically or radiologically, and the medical services are provided by a single medical practitioner. Then the third one is hospital, clinics, nursing homes, which are multi-practitioners. Means these are the hospitals or clinics where more than one treating physician is diagnosing or treating patients. The operational reason for this is that the nodal TB officer, district TB officer, has to deal with more than one doctor in hospitals where multi practitioners are working. So, whom to notify this TB patients? As a practitioner, as a health establishment, TB patients can be notified to a district nodal officer for tuberculosis. The updated list and the contact details, including the addresses, mobile numbers, email IDs of all district TB officers, are available on the official website of RNTCP, that is tbcindia.gov.in and nikshay.gov.in. So, these are the two websites where the updated list of all the contact details of the district TB officers who are responsible for ensuring TB notification in the district, is this list is available. Now, once we know that tuberculosis notification is important, we also need to know what are the tools available, how and how one can notify tuberculosis cases to the district TB officer. One can do it by sending the hard copy by post, courier or by hand. Alternatively, if agreed upon and if it is convenient to the health facilities, district TB officer can send his staff, the public health staff or the TB staff, to the health facilities which are registered to collect the information from time to time. Second way of notification is soft copy by email, which can be sent by the health facility in Word or Excel to the district TB officer. Third way is direct online reporting by Nikshay portal. One can register on this website as a health facility and self-notify from time to time. Fourth way is mobile application, which is downloadable from the same website, and the health facility or the practitioner can notify TB patients from time to time from his Android mobile. Recently, the government and the program has started a call center, a national call center with the number 1800116666. This is a toll-free number currently available in few states and is being expanded by World TB Day 2018 to all the states in the country. It will be available in 12 local languages. Currently, it is available in English and Hindi, and one can notify all TB patients being treated by them through this toll-free number. Thank you.